right, leave now. Go. I'm done. Fucking go.
5 out of 6 shows in Boise were fantastic. One of them was one of the toughest shows I've ever had. During the MC set, he tried to quiet people down a few times. It did not work. The problem was that it wasn't just one table. It was 4. 4 separate parties of people who would not shut up. It was hard to even figure out where it was all coming from. When Andrew Rivers went on, he tried to power through. Here's what it sounded like in between jokes. Occasionally, he would pepper in a comment like this.
I didn't know you guys were the listening type, but I'm impressed.
Some of the interruptions he'd address directly.
Are you confused about what's happening, or just... say just... Alright. What? Oh fuck, don't say anything.
And every time he'd try to go back into material...
It was Easter Sunday, I just figured, what would Jesus do, you know? Wait, what?
He's risen.
Yeah. Thank you for not contributing at all. I know I'm making it look so easy. You're like, he's just talking. Thank you. That was very relevant. Remember? Because he rose. That's not relevant to the story. The point is, what would Jesus do? Probably get hammered, is the joke. There you go. Goddamn right. The guy who doesn't pay attention got it. So, fuck you. Huh? What? Yeah, bro. Got it. Whatever. I don't understand that. Why are you here?
And then it became too much to handle.
Jesus Christ, you guys just shut the fuck up for once during this goddamn show.
Completely justified, Andrew snapped.
They're assholes in jail. Shut your fucking mouth. Why are you kicked out by now? Jesus Christ, just leave. No one likes you. You don't like the show. Fucking go, and I hate you. That's all I gotta say.
Andrew handled it as well as he possibly could have. He powered through his set for the most part, and he addressed it when he had to. So I started my show like this. By the way, there was a prom at the venue next door, and Eagle is a rich suburb of Boise.
I'm gonna start the show in a way I've never had to start a show before, which is to thank the people who came to see a show and who have been attentive thus far. I appreciate it. Some of you guys have been really wonderful. Some of you guys, I think, stumbled in from the prom next door. I don't know what the fuck is happening. But some of y'all have been acting like you've never seen alcohol before, and you took one sip and you lost your fucking mind. This is live entertainment. We can see y'all. We can hear y'all. You are ruining it for other people. Normally, when you talk at a show, there is a warning. And then if you violate that warning, you get kicked out. Everybody here now has that warning. We're gonna warn all of you at the same fucking time. It happens again. One time, you're fucking gone. Because I want to do the best show I possibly can for the folks who actually give a shit. So that's what I'm gonna do tonight, okay? And for those that ruin this, I wish you luck on your long drive back to Eagle. So.
The table that was the worst offender was told they had to leave. So they tried sneaking out the back door. I saw it happen and I called attention to it.
By the way, I just want to point out the table that was being chatty just tried to leave without paying their bill. Because that's the kind of people that they are. Don't be them. Don't be them. It's okay, the staff saw it. They chased them out. Don't worry about it. We'll figure it out. It'll work out. But they just tried to leave out the back door without paying their bill because they are classless, dumb motherfuckers. That's what happens sometimes. I hope y'all were raised better and we're gonna have a good show from here on out. Because we just exorcised the demons is what happened.
I thought that would be enough to turn the energy positive. And so the next time I got chatty, I just tried to make a joke out of it.
Let's get chatty. Fucking calm it down. I'm trying to be nice here. I'm trying to be nice. This shouldn't be that difficult. Y'all have been in a movie theater. It's like that, except the movie can fucking see you. Imagine if the middle of Avengers, Captain America was just like, shut the fuck up!
The talking got worse, and I tried my best to stay funny about it.
When adversity happens... When adversity happens, like it is tonight, you have a choice.
And then it kept going, so I tried to just encourage them politely to leave.
Is everything all right over there, this table?
Yes.
Okay, just getting...
Good.
You're good? Okay. Do you guys need like a cushion to leave or something? Okay, cool. Because if you could just not talk more, that would be cool. Thank you very much. I'm trying to be as polite as possible. Cool. Thank you.
By the time I got to my post-show Q&A, three tables had already been kicked out. There was one chatty table still left, and the table next to them had had enough.
The conversation's a form of education.
Guys, shut the fuck up, please.
Thank you. It's just really awkward at this point. It's like an uncle just touched us all at the same time. We don't know what to do. We're like, I don't want to go to Thanksgiving. No, it's not your fault at all. I agree with that. It's weird when the crowd heckles each other. That's a weird... It's not typical, but fuck it, it happened. If y'all want a souvenir from tonight, you can probably watch us all unfold on my YouTube channel. All right. Fuck it, I was at the crowd participation part, but some of y'all got a head start. If you want the albums, that'd be great. I also have my book with me, for those of you in the crowd that can read. I have my book, it's called Ginger Kid. It's a top 5 pick on Amazon, number 1 in its category. It's a true story of going through high school, getting bullied a whole lot, then finding comedy as a way out. Alright, leave now. Go. I'm done. Fucking go.
Bye.
Go. Yeah. It's so funny how many chairs are in the way right now. It's so funny. Like, I'm going, but... First, I gotta play Tetris to get the fuck out of here. Alright. I like how late timed that was, too. You were like, you said something to them, and he's just stewing for a little while. He's like, I gotta get her back. And then I made a joke about how some people here can't read, and he's like, that's the one. I didn't mean to write for him. It's a weird credit. Like, I've written for like award shows and shit and some TV, and now I've also written for someone getting mad at her, so. It's bizarre. I kind of appreciate that you guys stay, because you're like, fuck them, which is nice. You're like, I'll deal with them later. Who are they to you guys? How do you know them? You don't talk about it. In fairness, that's totally okay. If you guys are just like, we abstain. We gave birth to one, and then she dated that guy. So, was I correct, or was it the other way around? You're like, I do not wish this to be entered into state's evidence, sir. You'd only do the fifth in a courtroom. This is not a courtroom. All right, so if you want to pick up a copy of the book, I'm pretty sure y'all can read it, so if you guys want to buy it, then read it to them later, that would be great. I love that you guys stand, that's my favorite thing, because when he got up and he was like, I'm getting the fuck out of here, and you guys were like, all right, we've been... I didn't realize, because you never know the dynamic of a table. You never know who's who, and I just hear the table being chatty, and you never really know who's who. And then we learned, because he's like, I'm getting the fuck out of here. And you guys were also like, fucking finally. We've been trying to enjoy the show silently this whole time. All right. I hope they had fun at prom, though. I hope they did. So, okay. So if you want to pick up a copy of the book, that's awesome, just apologize to them. This is great, this is like, we're getting like all Kumbaya and Oprah and shit here now. This is lovely. I appreciate that. That's really nice of you. I appreciate that. I'm gonna move on to another table because they clearly don't want to participate, so.
By the end of the show, 4 tables of 9 people had been thrown out. I've never seen anything like that at a show before, and I hope to never see it again. Thanks for watching my videos, for subscribing on my YouTube, and for liking my page on Facebook. Also, thanks for supporting the Patreon. When you do, you get videos before anybody else. You also get t-shirts and albums, and you can even Skype or FaceTime with me. If you want me to perform near you, my new podcast is out. It's called Failing Forward, and it's available on podcasting services everywhere. Subscribe to that, and you make Walter happy. He's so little back there. Come see a live show. If I'm not performing near you, you can bug one of your local venues to have me out. That kind of stuff really helps. But here are some of the cities where I am performing. Salt Lake City, Utah, Denver, Colorado, Providence, Rhode Island, Albany, New York, Edmonton, Ottawa, and Sydney in Canada, Portland, Oregon, and Seattle, Washington, Brookings, South Dakota, Emporia, Kansas, Charlotte, North Carolina, Nashville, Tennessee, and many more. Check out the details and get your tickets at stevehofstetter.com. Isn't that right, far away, Walter?